beast hunting, more cyberverse, more apex armor, and more breakdown. And this time he's green. Two battle modes, rapid fire missiles, green breakdown, tech specs, back of box, other side. Let's empty it out.
So before we get into the apex armor and the tank and all that good stuff, let's look at breakdown individually by himself. He is a green version of himself. Kind of weird, especially since he's quite dead, but we'll see what happens. Hope I didn't spoil that for anybody. But here's the original breakdown, the blue one that we all came to know and love or hate, depending if you liked good or bad guys. But that's it. Not too spectacular here. Let's get him transformed.
Well, here we have him in his robot mode, and yeah, he looks cool. Looks all right. I mean, I don't know. Don't really think green for breakdown, but hey, whatever. Here he is in his original mode. And I got to say, the tolerances and the plastic on this one feel a little bit nicer than on the original, if that makes any sense. So yeah, there they are together.
All right, man, let's roll in this hog. Oh yeah, look at missiles everywhere. You can see guns and missiles, claws coming at you. This thing rolls up and down your street, in your neighborhood. You just get out of its way. And that's all I got to say about it. Liking that, man. Look at, and you try to run, boom, get you from the side.
Okay, all messing around aside, let's just have a quick look at this. It's got a very, very vibrant green color scheme, and I quite like this green. I don't know why. I think I'm starting to like green a lot. I think maybe because I'm in an office all day and never get to see it. So, yeah, that's it. You know, a lot of molded and tacky bits. Now, this is a reuse of the mold. It's kind of a remold, a little bit retool, I should say, of the Bumblebee battle suit. So we're going to get that out and do the side-by-side really quick, just showing it off to you.
All right, here it is, side-by-side, and I like having both of them because, you know, you can make them fight, you can play, they're play sets, you play with them, boom, you know, now you got an enemy, this one gets in that one, you use your imagination, everybody's happy and having a good time. I think the difference here between these two is that they've got some different gimmicks, though, that separate them, besides a little bit of the remolding bits, and some of the stuff is just straight up reuse of the mold. Well, this guy's got some friction missiles. He's got four of them in the front, and he's got some spring-loaded claws. Whereas this guy, he's got this gun that comes in different pieces, but if you see here this wire, he's got LEDs, so this dude lights up. If I had a choice, I always go with the light-up gimmicks because shiny things make me happy.
Before I did all that blabbing, I probably should have put the actual figures that it came with inside the tanks, so there they are now.
All right, so let's just have a look at the main gimmick here. This is the main turret of the tank. And just like the Bumblebee one, this you can move this around. So you can actually hold it in the bigger figure's hands and stuff too. But I like this. It's very organic. It almost looks like a dragon body or snake or something. I don't know, but use your imagination there. It's all like, you know, claws or whatever. This is kind of cool, though. As you turn these, you can see this right here. They're individual. It's almost like a sprue, like a worm gear or something. And as you do this, these will start firing individually, one at a time. Kind of a neat little gimmick. I like neat new things, and this makes me happy too.
A little on-screen transformation, because this is very simple. You just simply, you take this stuff, and you go like that, and it hides these back here. You can tuck these in a little farther, and then extend that platform up. You then just kind of stand it up, right? You take this all forward. These feet here tip in, and then there's a little peg that goes like this. Let's see if I can aim that there. Crank that down. Same with this side, like this. In the little peg hole, there it is. And voila, you're done. So the Apex armor does have a little articulation in his arms here. These will kind of go out to the side. They're on clicky joints, and he's got bend at the elbow. And then if you pull back these, yeah, pinch ya. All right, so I've inserted my breakdown into the chest cavity there. I've also taken this post and put it up here so you can utilize that port there. That port there goes right about here. Now I can use this like a giant hand cannon. And I really like the aesthetic of this thing. The colors, the way it looks. Like the Apex armor, I think it's kind of a win. Doesn't have LEDs, but you see that missile thing, didn't ya? I gotta say, this does look pretty cool. As well, if you don't like these or not, aesthetically, I think they look pretty neat. That looks nice together. And I like having them on the shelf just like that. I also like the idea that Silas is inside a breakdown, who's inside another big giant mech suit.
Okay, there's just one more size comparison, and that is with the other current Cyberverse playset that's available. So just to show you what you're getting if you're looking for one or the other. So that's been it, folks. This has been Mitch Santona. You have just seen Apex Hunter Armor with Breakdown from the Transformers Prime Beast Hunters subline. This is a Cyberverse playset that I pretty much recommend. I like both of them. I like the one with smokescreen too. I think they both look really, really amazing looking. And I think they both have a lot of playability. So that's it. Take care. Arrivederci. I will see you guys later. I got some more Transformers goodies coming your way. Stay tuned for that, and have a good one.